Gene editing of hematopoietic stem cells indeed holds great promise for therapeutic purposes, especially for treating immune and blood diseases. So basically, genome editing is based on the exploitation of programmable nucleases, which are a sort of molecular scissors that can specifically cut a precise site of interest into the genome. So after the cut, we can exploit the natural repair mechanisms of the cell that the cell used to repair the damage normally. So these pathways are main non-homologous end joining pathway or homology-driven repair pathway. So by non-homologous end joining, in the non-homologous end joining pathway, there is an error-prone way to repair the damage. So random bases are inserted or deleted at the cut site, while with the in the HDR pathway, the cell exploits a donor DNA template, like, for example, the sister chromatid, to repair specifically the damage in a faithful way, so by copying the other chromosome. We can imagine for therapeutic purposes to exploit non-homologous end joining to knock out genes, for example, CCR5 for treating HIV, or to disrupt enhancers such as the PCL11A for the sickle cell disease, while HDR can be used to specifically correct disease-causing mutations or substitution, thus basically in situ correcting genes and their function, but also to we can exploit HDR to perform gene addition in safe harbor loci, like AVS1 or also the CCR5 itself. In hematopoietic stem cells, the main, let's say, restriction linked to the usage of this pathway is that HDR is a little bit restricted, while non-homologous end joining is more, hematopoietic stem cells are more permissive to non-homologous end joining than if compared to HDR. So for this reason, the field is moving a lot, trying to improve the HDR efficiencies in hematopoietic stem cells. For example, by inhibiting p53 pathway, by promoting the cell cycle, or by tethering Cas9 protein to non-homologous end joining inhibitors or HDR promoters, let's say. In general, what we can say on genome editing is that if compared to standard gene therapy, it allows to overcome some limitations like the risk of insertional mutagenesis, while on the other hand, it also allows to expand the number of diseases that we can treat because there are diseases that require a granular control of the expression of the gene in order to avoid the development of several of serious adverse events, like is the case of hyper-IgM1. On one hand, there are these advantages in respect to standard gene therapy, but on the other hand, we have also some drawbacks beyond the existence of the off-target events that we all know. There is also the problem in hematopoietic stem cells of the toxicity of double-strand break into these cells. For this reason, the scientific community is now moving towards the development of new tools such as base editors, prime editors, or CRISPR associated transposases that aim to overcome the generation of a double strand break, like the nuclease, and to correct specific mutations without inducing double strand breaks into the cell. And I think that also this field is moving very fast, especially with base editors. And I think it's of interest, of course, to be following in the next years.